Namaste, I am Manjula. Welcome to Manjula's Kitchen. Today I will be making aloo ki kachori. This is a delicious spicy fried puffed bread. Aloo kachori can be part of the main meal or it can even be served for breakfast with a hot cup of chai. This kachori also makes a mouth-watering appetizer that can be served with green chutney as a chaat. This recipe will make 12 kachoris and will serve 4. To make aloo ki kachori, we will need. For dough, we need 1 cup of all-purpose flour, plain flour or maida, 2 tablespoons of oil, I like to use canola oil, 2 tablespoons of fine suji or semolina, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, few drops of lemon juice. Lemon juice gives an extra crispness to kachori and also help absorbing less oil. We also need approximately 1/3 cup of chilled water. For filling, we need 1 cup of mashed potatoes. I have already boiled, peeled and mashed. It took me about 1.5 potato. 1/2 teaspoon of salt. 1 tablespoon of oil, 1/2 teaspoon of cumin seed, jeera, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, dhania, 1/2 teaspoon of mango powder, amchur, 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder, approximately 2 tablespoon of finely chopped cilantro, hara dhania, and 1 tablespoon of finely chopped green chili. So first, I will make the dough. For that, all-purpose flour, semolina, salt, and just few drops of lemon juice and oil. Now we can mix everything together. So after this is mixed, we will add the water slowly. Now when you are making the dough, do not knead the dough. Everything should just come together. So and add the water slowly. So dough is looking good, it is very soft, but make sure you do not knead the dough too much because kachoris will not be very crisp. So and now this should rest for at least 10 minutes. Let's prepare the filling. Heat is on medium. I like to use the heavy pan. So first I will add the oil. Oil should be moderately hot before we add the cumin seeds. So add the cumin seed. Cumin seed should crack right away. Now we will add the green chilies and cilantro. Lower the heat. Stir for few seconds. Add the potatoes. Salt, red chili powder, amchur, mango powder and coriander powder. Keep mixing. Mix it well and keep pressing when you are mixing it so it's nicely cooked. Potatoes should be moist but not very moist. Otherwise, kachoris will not be crisp. So keep pressing when you are mixing the filling. As you see, I am making a very spicy mix because I like spicy. But you can adjust the chilies to your taste. Filling is ready and we will keep this aside. Filling should be just moist enough so we can make it as a soft dough. So dough has been sitting for about 15 minutes with the damp towel. So now we are ready to fill the kachoris. And just knead a little bit, not much. Okay, dough is good. Now I have oiled my palm. So divide the dough into 12 equal parts. Filling is also ready. It is on room temperature. So just make it as a dough. And if there is a big lumps of potato, just break them. And now we are ready to fill. Okay. So take the ball right between your palms and roll them. And then just go around with your finger, making it like a cup. Center part should be thicker. Now take about the same size as dough, the filling, put it in and wrap it around, just stretching the dough. Do all of them the same way. I have filled all the balls for kachoris. Heat is on medium. And oil should be just hot enough that when you put the kachori, they should sizzle and come up slowly. So I am going to roll the kachoris with back of my palm. You can use the rolling pin, but this works better. So put the seam size up, press it with your finger, and then just go around. It's not very hard. And just put it in the oil. And as you see, it's sizzling, but it is taking some time to come up. Do the next one. Don't overlap the kachoris, but I think I can put one more. Don't turn the kachori till they puff up. So we can turn this kachori. So make sure you don't overlap the kachoris, they will not puff up. And after they puff, then it's time to turn. You do have to turn them 3 to 4 times and cook them till both sides they are golden brown. So these two kachoris are looking good from this side. That's just the right color. So just turn them over and see. Now I think this side need a little bit more. So I will turn it over. So now turn them around again. And now this side is looking just right. So both sides are cooked and very crisp. So take them out on the plate. And I always like to take it out over the paper towel so it can absorb the extra oil. Okay, all the kachoris are done and they are looking really nice and crispy. Aloo ki kachori are looking delicious and ready to serve. Today I will be serving aloo kachori with tomato chutney with sliced ripe banana. That's how my mom liked to serve. This recipe is perfect to make for any occasion all year around and will be great treat for all your guests. Please leave a like If you would like to give this recipe a try and leave a comment down below if you do. Until we meet again, check out more recipes on manjulaskitchen.com. Thank you.